Good morning, everybody. It is Monkeypuzzle, and I hope you will join me today for episode number 10, A Day in the Life of a Monkeypuzzle. Sort of. I've got a bunch of things to show you today, and we'll see what we get done. First, one day I woke up and I saw this cute little creature here. It's a little monkey. What do you call these guys? A little mesopithecus for me from Arali. So that's very sweet. He even has a little green hat. So I'm very happy about that. Let's go ahead and really make him ours. So he's going to be an MP. And we're going to name him Minky. It's from a Peter Sellers skit from the Pink Panther. Inspector Clouseau, a Minky. Anyway, look up Seeing Eye Minky or Monkey, and you'll see the skit I'm talking about. Anyway, there he is on his proper place. A monkey with a monkey. So that is very good. Thank you, Arali. I really appreciate that. Been missing a monkey on my shoulder. I actually went around with Dodo Kibble for a while, hoping to find one. And here is one found. So I still have a little bit of a cold, so excuse me if I sound a little stopped up, but I just want to continue recording, cold or no cold. So a few things to catch you up on first. Let me see, I got a lot of nice comments in the last episode where we made this greenhouse over here. And let me see, to start with, fellow named Karmic Coffee 97. Well, I shouldn't assume it's a fellow. But somebody named Karmic Coffee 97 suggested I put stone railings all around the harbor, make it look a little bit more built in and safer to hold on to in case of a storm. So there we go. We got stone railings all the way around. Won't really keep me, maybe it will, from falling into the water. That's good. We want to be able to jump off if we need to. And then see, what else can I show you? Over here, it's a small thing, but it gives me immense pleasure. I managed to shorten the water intake into the greenhouse so that it wasn't sticking all the way out. That's the kind of thing that the Monkeypuzzle appreciates. Oh, and then a fellow named Eben Bennett gave me a tip. So we figured out that to build this thing, we had to put supports right here. Well, he said that if I took the sides off with that model gun, that model selector, you'd barely see it. And it's true, you can barely see it. You can kind of see sort of prismatic little difference in tone there, but it's a lot better than when it had the sides and was all uglified. So that was a very nice tip right there. Otherwise, the greenhouse has been doing great. We've been getting tons of crops in here, which we've been using for various things. One of them being to make veggie cakes for all these snails. So we're going to go get a snail real quick. Just going to show you my process for that. I found that once it fills with the achatina paste, which is a one-for-one equivalent with cementing paste, then it fills with all this organic polymer, which is just amazing. I leave it in there till I need it because it spoils pretty quickly. So no way to really stockpile it without turning it into something. I saw somebody turning it into scuba gear and then putting the scuba gear in the grinder later, but the amount you lost wasn't really worth it. Oh, that's funny. Leveling his health made him so unhealthy that he goes into his shell to hide. All right, so that's that for those guys. And right now that's like 500 cementing paste every 20 minutes or so. Ooh. That's a nice one. I might have to get that for somebody. 162. Oh, and you can see, oh, huh, Big Bertha must have fought someone or else was avoiding the advances of this guy who was trying to climb down the cliff and lost his nerve climbing down. He's a Bronto and he's not very good at climbing. So I actually have a couple. Ooh, that's all it took. 168 pteranodons. Up in there. They were 168 when I caught them because I kind of just bumped into them just like that, even more literally, and I can't really pass it up. So this will be a gift for somebody on the server. I could probably get some prime or some dodo kibble to stick on it. probably going to save the dodo kibble for an ichthyosaurus. I had a bunch of dodo kibble on me the other day because I was looking for an ichthyosaurus, and a pegomastax stole it off me, like 22 of them. It's pretty ridiculous. So that was pretty silly indeed. So I got to make some more dodo kibble. Do I have some in here at this point? Let's see if we have any left. Well, I do have some dodo eggs, so I'll make those up. It's only going to take about 3 of them for that pteranodon. Let me go ahead and look up the recipe again, and then I'll show you something else. A bunch of things to show you. Okay, got it. Reminded myself of that. Let's put the gun away before we hurt somebody. So we just need cooked meat, which I actually had some on me, actually up in here. I can do this. Some major berries as well. And then some rock root. Let's see if we have some in here. We do. And then over here, we've got some upgrades. Aaron BLP made all this stuff. We've got the industrial cooker, which is awesome, awesome. And the chem bench, which is even more awesome, awesome. If you don't know, these make all the stuff you can make in the mortar and pestle way more quickly, just like tons more quickly, and you get a 50% bonus on the production. So that's just amazing. So it's all powered. We have to put gas and stuff in it, but yeah, that's there. And then there's one more upgrade we're going to implement later. All right, and so this thing is way more quick too. You can see some tree sap in there. We're going to get into that in a second. Let's just put all that stuff in there, turn this on, and hopefully I have everything we need to make some dodo kibble. That pteranodon, of course, was completely unplanned. I did just tame another female dodo so that we can get some more eggs and keep the dodo kibble coming. I've actually never used kibble this much before, but it's pretty fun and it's totally worth it. It saves time, gives you levels. Let's get this stuff back because waste not, want not. Oh, and I put a little chair there too because we might do some fishing at some point, especially with all this tree sap. Gotta go get some leech blood too. I actually haven't done any fishing yet in the game, so that would be pretty cool. Cool. I mean, this, we don't need most of this. That's probably more than we need. And then what else can I show you? Over here is Tardy, that Therizinosaurus that we got a few episodes back. Amazing beast. We've been totally depending on it for harvesting and protection. All its amazingness. Yes, you are. So I was going for that ichthyosaurus the other day. I made a little raft with some beds on it and went out there. And before I saw a good ichthy, I saw a good megalodon, the shark. She's a female. And get her up in the light. She's actually pink. Let's see. Let's get some good light over here, maybe. There you are. It's a pink shark. It's very nice. So happy about that. I recorded some of it. I did not have my mic on at the time. So if we have time this episode, I'll show you some of that because it was pretty exciting at points. I didn't have proper prime and stuff like that. So I was attacking other megalodons in the water with my sword, trying to get some prime, at least some fish prime at the time. Fish prime at the time. All right, so we may see some of that later, see how the time goes. Let's go ahead and drop some of this kibble on that random pteranodon over here. Let's see who needs one. I've got an excess of these at this point. So we'll just put all that on. Probably going to be one too many. Yeah, let's take one off and we'll save that. Yeah, two more bites should do it. So we're probably pretty safe just leaving that there. We can go ahead and maybe give it a bodyguard. It's going to wake up with attack my target, but just in case some dillos or something come around. Although that won't really help because it'll still attack that or it'll attack this. Whatever, makes me feel good. All right, so let's get on with some other stuff I planned. Oh, let me see. A couple more things to show you. Let me check my notes real quick. Ah, yes. So up in the lighthouse here, just did a little home decorating that I want to show you. You can see, yeah, we've got quite a few pteranodons in here. Not all ours. Neocryptor has left one sort of for boarding here. And then also, I guess it's upstairs. You're supposed to be shut. Let's go on up here. Yeah, we have Lexus Arcades for safekeeping because she's on vacation with her family. And Aaron used the Megalosaurus the other day to catch himself an RG. It was a level 176, so that is awesome. Again, we're on difficulty 6 here, so our dinos go up to 180, which is pretty amazing. He used the Megalosaurus, and I also need to tell you what's going on here, but you can see, let me just finish that story first, is that there, in the new patch, you're supposed to be able to clamp onto a thing and then dismount and have it still clamp it. Well, it doesn't really work, as at least as we think it must have been intended, because when you get off, it chews and eats the thing it's clamping, so he couldn't quite do it solo, still had to get Cryo to come help him trank it. But anyway, started putting the artifacts up here as part of the lighthouse. I thought that was appropriate, and you know what this means, is now we have to get more artifacts. Yes, we do, to fill this out. And then, yeah, we have the little Knights of the Round Table thing going on, or at least Knights around the platform smithy. So, yeah, just moving in. Whee! All right, so on with some stuff. Right, I should have whistled Bumpus while I was up there, but no matter. Come on, Bumpus. We've got things to do. And it looks like it's getting to be nighttime already, so actually, sigh, I may have to wait. So I'll see you in about 10 minutes. Something like that. Alrighty, it's daytime again, and before we fly off, one more thing I wanted to show you was that Jack Spyro actually gifted us with a Troodon. I have not had the patience to do what it takes to tame one of these, and plus I despise them for being so vicious and killing me more than once out there in the wilds at night while I was chasing the raptor claws drops. Indeed, these things are terrible. And he offered it before, and I actually turned them down because I read there's a thing where they can turn on you if you don't give them enough attention, so I have them locked in the taming box here. Hopefully it won't eat our tames as I throw them in. You're past that, right? I think this one was actually bred. If you look inside of it and view the ancestor list, it has wild ancestors, and it was, I believe, tamed? I think, or maybe not. I can't tell. Is this what it looks like when you tame it? Or, I guess, maybe it wasn't tamed. I don't know. Or bred, what I meant to say. But there it is. Trinity BMP. So, thank you, I think, Jack Spyro. Alright, so let me fly off to the redwoods and the swamps, and we will continue from there. Alright, so coming in on the redwoods, last time you saw me put this tree sap tap here. This is the regular tree sap tap. It's got one slot, and you get 20 tree tap sap, blip, 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 blip. And two people commented on that episode, Bobby One Kenobi and B-Fun, and told me that there is indeed a S+, a Structures Plus tree tap sap. And that is this. And among other things, you can pick it up and move it if you want. And it's also got a lot more slots, which we thought it would accumulate 100 rather than stopping at 20. But the thing is, it actually still stops at 20. So I'm not sure if it's bugged out or what, but at least I can pick them up and move them. Not that I'm going to, but at least the main benefit was that it got me to make 3 more. So I've got these on all these trees over here. So let me go ahead and finish collecting that. So I get 80 sap every time I come out here to do this. Yep, not quite. Alright, so we got a bunch of sap. And now we can go and make a bunch of sweet vegetable cakes when we go back to the base. But first thing I want to do is find yet another snail. I've got a little snail addiction right now, and whenever I don't know what to do with myself, breaking the trees, I go out and look for a snail. They're uncommon in the redwoods, but can be found. But they are common in the swamps. So I kind of cruise this perimeter between the swamps and the redwoods, and I tend to find one every time. It's a little tricky because there's a lot of rocks that look like snails, and you got to be careful because right now a Caprosuchus could knock me right off here, which would not be good. One thing to do to prepare for that is to make sure that your mount is on neutral, so if you do get knocked off and killed, they don't kill your mount. That's pretty important. And then you just gotta keep an eye out. Don't have to cruise quite this low, but just trying to find that snail. And generally I find one right around here, but I won't just fill it with words. I'll skip until I actually find one. But what I'm doing is preparing to have tons of cementing paste so that we can do all the things we want to do. For instance, I'll show you where we've decided to make our main base for this season. And I want to play with a lot of the platforms plus stuff. And those take a lot of cementing paste. Here we go. There is a snail. Let's go ahead and grab it and get up, make sure we have it. There we go. I got snail. If you look, you can see the little blurriness of the slime trail underneath. Alright, so I'm going to head back and just we'll tame this guy up and then we'll do some more stuff. Okay, coming into home here. Let's see if I can do this on one try. It does happen occasionally. Hey, hey! There it is. And the Troodon did not eat it. So that's excellent. So before I tame it, let's do a couple things. You're not following me, right? That's good. Just grab some stem berries from the greenhouse. I'm overloaded now. But I was too lazy to go harvest some out there. But you can see that Pteranodon tamed up to level 242. That's not bad at all. Nice health, nice stamina. Okay, wait. Oh, and pretty good melee damage and speed. All right, back over here. Let's go ahead and put the stem berries in here. And put some more of the tree sap in here. And then look at all that lovely, beautiful, luscious cementing paste that we built up in like 20, 30 minutes. There'll be this much more. And there's going to be even one more stack this time because we've got another snail. So to make sweet veggie cakes, you need stimulant. And stimulant is made with stem berries and spark powder. So go ahead and put that in there. And then we should be able to turn this on and make some of this lickety split. That's pretty cool. And you can see when it says 14, it's actually 14 times 6. Which is awesome. And then also to make this, we need some crops. So it's all the crops except lemon, and I kind of remember that as being snails wouldn't want the acid of the lemon. That's just my little trick for remembering. So here in the cooker now, we can go ahead and put the rest of that stuff, the stimulant, the rocker root, the long grass, and the potatoes, the sava root. And I think that's all of it, plus 25 fiber each as sort of a binder. And let's see if I got it right. If we did, it'll happen real quick, because that's one of the benefits of the cooker. So I've actually made a ton of this stuff already, but I thought I'd make some with you. And I keep getting snails, so I can keep making this stuff. And it's also good to have on your herbivores. If they get hurt, you can heal them up with this stuff. It's been nerfed because of the PvPers, but it's still one of the only good ways to really heal up your herbivore in the field in the midst of battle or right after battle. And then we're out of stimulant, so that's it. Take all that, quite a bit of it, and then we'll need to get some more tree sap. We pretty much used all that up. Oh, and I can't move. All right, I'm going to figure this out, and I'll see you in a second. And the snail. Is alive, but very, very injured. I'm not sure how that happened unless it was injured already. You didn't do it, did you? You look very guilty, or at least look suspiciously not guilty. You know what I'm going to do? I'm actually going to make a magnifying glass because I don't have one of those yet, and that would be handy for stuff like this. Make sure I don't kill it when I trank it. So the magnifying glass uses 16, and it wants me to learn the spyglass first, of course. I'm actually getting pretty low on Engram, so I may have to make a mind wipe soon, or else level up real quick. The chembench is actually good for that, because you can grind out a lot of levels really quick using it. So I'm assuming that I need to make this in... Oh, I can make it in my inventory. Let me get that stuff, and we'll do this real quick. Okay, there it is. We have a magnifying glass. Now, this thing has limited uses, but one of them is being able to look at the health and torpor of your tames. So it can come in handy, especially if you're trying to do some science or not kill something. Oops. Oh, God. That was the wrong thing. Right click, not left click. So it's only got 16 out of 150 health. Wow. Wonder what happened with that. All right. Well, it looks like I'm going to get another snail and let this one sit. There's no shooting it. And this thing looks like it hasn't moved, but I don't trust it. I'm going to come up with some other place to put this guy. Okay. There you go. Nope. Can I punch it? It doesn't like it. There. You stay put forever and ever. We'll feed you occasionally. All right. You heal up, and I'm going to go get another one. In the meantime, I'll meet you back here. Okay, there is another. Hopefully, it's nice and healthy. Okay, snail male number two. There you go. See if this one's in better shape. Much better. That one has not died or despawned yet, so we'll just do this one. Not the most scary tame at all. I'm not sure if there's a difference in shooting it in its shell or not. They don't have a whole lot of torpor, so this generally doesn't take long. And also because they don't have a whole lot of torpor, look, it only's got 137. It drops really quickly, so you have to keep an eye on it. But the only thing that I think you can tame them with is those sweet vegetable cakes. So we got through the process to get to this, and we're obviously accumulating them, and that's going to lead to us being rich in cementing paste. Oh, and I should mention, I've got some really high level ones in there. Like, I think one was started as like a 174, but the level really makes absolutely no difference with these because they produce the same amount of cementing paste either way. Okay, there it is. I haven't even been bothering to name these things. Just take the rest of those so they don't eat them. Apparently in the future, that's all they can eat. So, I should be able to pick this up. Oh, it's because I have my Minky. Hang out for a second, Minky. Now I can pick this up and go ahead and put it in the greenhouse. But even though they can only eat the veggie cakes, they don't get hungry very quickly at all. So only have to feed them once on a blue moon. One thing you got to do with these is first, though, we don't need them on attack my target. I don't think that would do a whole lot. And they need to be on wandering. And then with that, we now have 6 snails making paste. And who knows when I will stop. So just wanted to show you my process for that. No big deal. But when I have like crates and crates full of cementing paste, I want you guys to see. Come on, let me through. How I did it. So hopefully you'll heal up. I wish I could feed it a veggie cake right now to heal it up, but I don't know how to do that. One more thing I want to accomplish in this episode. And we're going to get up to the top of the volcano and I'll show you what it is. I guess this is sort of a catch-up and productivity episode. So up here on the top of the volcano, which is not too far away from our little spawn town, there's a ton of metal nodes up here. It's pretty cool. And right in the middle of it, we've set up a little forge thing here, which is pretty cool. Ankylo egg. I'll take it. So far, we've only had the regular stone forges to be able to do this with. But now, here, among the other industrial things that Aaron BLP made, we have an industrial forge. So I was going to upgrade this scene to that. Now, the respawn radius is turned down really low on this server, which I like a lot because you can have trees and plants and stuff near your base. You can also put this in the middle here near these metal nodes. And the respawn radius, I think, is only like 2.5 spaces. Well, we should bust this metal node, make sure that it comes back before the end. Right here. And you also don't want to have, just as a side note, you don't want to have your Enki standing where this will respawn, because if I left it right here and that respawned, it would disappear the Enki. So we'll move it out away from there and keep its tail pointed that way, basically to see if that one comes back, and then we'll know that we're good. So what I want to do right now is clear all this stuff off. Oh, it's got metal in it. And then put the refining forge down. So just for time's sake, I'm going to do that off camera. And then I'll show you what's going on. And by the way, these are S+ refining forges so that we can just pick them up. I could use the demo gun for that too. And I believe that means they also have extra slots. I don't remember how many refining forge has, but I think 50 is more than usual. Not quite done rearranging things, but just wanted to show you all the placing of the forge. Thank you, Aaron BLP, for making it. Woohoo. Okay, everybody, I got it all done. Everything's all rearranged here. You can check it out. You saw me put down the industrial forge. Got all of these crafting stations down here to be storage and the signs behind so people can label what's going on here. We've got the forges down here in case this is being used and someone's not in a hurry. More storage, and then these for making the spark powder, which is fuel that's available up here to run these forges. And you can see I put a nice little sign here. Oops. So people can read the rules, see what's going on, get a little indicator of how to use the place. Got a nice trough down there for the Enki, whose name is Feed Me. Just as a little reminder, so folks don't forget, and it's a common Anki. It'll stay up here. And then also you can see that that metal node that I harvested did respawn. So that is far enough away from all the metal nodes. Based on the settings of this particular server, generally it's much larger. And last time we actually had to make the community forge up there so that it didn't interfere with any of the spawns. So this should work great. We should be able to keep ourselves in metal ingots much more easily. And so with the cementing paste, this is the next step in having all the mats needed to make all the fancy stuff for the next stages of the game. And let me see, I can pull this guy up a little bit further. And then you can see, you can pull him in here and do all the things you need to do. You can unload the raw metal and stick it on in here. You can see I already made a bunch of ingots. And this thing is so great. It's really fast. I think it does something like 12 at a time. I forget. Let me see. That's 139. There you go. It's down to 99. So what's that? That's 40 at a time. That's amazing. So the I guess the S Plus one is even a little bit better than the vanilla one. It's pretty cool. You can pick it up. You can rename it. And then let me see. If there's extra stone, if you didn't toss it outside there, you can put it in here to make some more of the spark powder. And I've just got a couple of these labeled so far. This one's for extra gas, so you can leave this going, but just put as much as it needs in there and not burn up all the gas. And this one is for obsidian, because sometimes you have too many metal ingots and you need some place to put that. So this is a little extra store of obsidian. So it's all ready to be used. Pretty exciting. Nice community asset for... Oh, wow, it's foggy. For the community. So I think that's it today. I am out of time to show you the shark fight, so I'm sorry about that. Just know it was pretty epic. Me in the with the sword in the water, fighting sharks, trying to get Prime to tame that nice one, the nice pink female we got back there. So anyway, plenty more stuff coming up. Next time I'm going to show you where BLP and I are going to make our main base, start making preparations for that, and plenty of other things to go. I got lots of creatures I still want to tame and many other ideas besides that. So I will see you in the next episode. Thank you for watching until the very end. This has been Monkeypuzzle once again. Bye-bye.